Advanced Water Resources Engineering Channel. The term water resources are given to any source of natural water on the surface of the earth, regardless of its physical state, whether solid, liquid or gas, provided that the source is of potential benefit to humans. The water of rivers, seas, and oceans is the most used source, and human use of water resources, especially fresh water, continues to increase with time, due to the increasing need for water in the agricultural, industrial, and entertainment fields. Water covers 71% of the Earth's surface. Most of the water on Earth is salt water, 97%, while only 3% of water resources are fresh water, and more than two-thirds of fresh water resources are present in frozen form in polar ice caps and ice caps. The rest of the fresh water resources that are not frozen are found in groundwater, and the rest is in the form of lakes, rivers, and streams on the surface of the earth or in the form of water vapor. Although fresh water resources are from renewable resources, the water reserves of groundwater are constantly declining, which may threaten the environmental balance, especially since there is no clear picture of the extent of the risk of disturbing this balance. The Earth contains large quantities of fresh water represented by surface and groundwater. 40% of it is used for public and ever-increasing consumption, which often exceeds the rate of population growth, and water consumption has doubled at least twice in the 20th century. In addition to this depletion, water resources suffer from various forms of pollution, and if water contamination continues at the current rate, with increasing amounts of water used, this will lead to the depletion of fresh water soon. Today, there are 88 developing countries, which make up 40% of the world's population, whose water shortage is a serious impediment to social and economic development. All of the above leads to a quantitative and qualitative depletion of natural resources and their exploitation in quantities that exceed their natural regeneration rate. In order for a person to be able to settle, develop, and live in peace, a safe and sufficient source of water must be available to meet his daily needs. In many areas, the search for water was the reason why many people endured the hardship of traveling and traveling in search of it. Man realized the importance of basin management about 2,500 years ago. Plato, 348-428 BC, noted graphically the effect of changes in land use on river discharge. In recent years, the management of the basins has gained special importance, while recognizing the importance and effectiveness of water sustainability projects as a key element of human well-being and to the increase in population and animal and agricultural production. The medium and large projects of the management of the basins need large and economic capital that is not feasible unless its benefits benefit the residents of the region and ensure continuity and sustainability of these projects for a long time. The management of basins in the broadest sense can be considered to ensure improvement in the hydrological system, soil, and biological systems and the preservation of the land from degradation and optimal use of the basin. Changing the patterns of land use affects water and soil systems. These changes, if properly planned, can be useful, but if they are not properly planned, they may be harmful. This is what happens in developing countries where these changes are random. The root cause of these changes is undoubtedly the continued increase in population and animal production where land is used for agriculture, pastoral purposes, and deforestation. This is what happened in Sudan in 1975-1977, where many areas suffer from deterioration, as in Nepal, China, Ethiopia, Thailand, India, and others. Currently, two major problems arise as a result of poor management of basins. First, the increase in the sediments in the reservoirs, which reduces the capacity of the tank. Second, change the flow pattern due to logging and reduce vegetation. Basin management in Western countries is different from basin management in Asian and African countries due to many reasons, such as climate variability, annual rainfall, etc., making transfer of technology and knowledge from one country to another dangerous. Hence the importance of water as a natural resource and the need for sound management. The management and exploitation of water resources require expeditious efforts, tremendous potential, and extensive experience in the field of water resources, in terms of searching for their resources, accurately estimating their quantity and knowing their quality. The scientific development in the field of computers has been represented by programs of geographic information systems and the availability of spatial data information represented by satellite images and data of digital elevation model DEM and mathematical models and others, and linked to the study of water resources, emerged models of simulation of water resources which are mathematical business models that combine mathematical and logical concepts that try to real-life system simulation through the use of computer programs. Among the types of simulation modeling in water resources engineering: 1. Hydrological modeling. 2. Hydraulic modeling. Hence, the idea of the work of this channel that explains advanced methods in dealing with simulation modeling programs in water resources engineering, and how to obtain and prepare all the completion requirements for these programs, has emerged. Thus providing all that is new and advanced for specialists, researchers, and students in the field of water resources and the completion of projects in a professional format through the use of computer programs for hydrological and hydraulic modeling in addition to programs for modeling different irrigation methods. Water use in agriculture is at the heart of any discussion of water and food security. On average, agriculture receives 70% of all water withdrawals worldwide, and even has a greater share of that water consumption due to crop needs as a result of evaporation and transpiration. Worldwide, more than 330 million hectares are equipped for irrigation. Irrigated agriculture accounts for 20% of the total cultivated land, but it contributes 40% to the total food production in the world. And implicitly, the channel is concerned with calculating, finding, and estimating all elements of the hydrological cycle, using the best methods and criteria. Whereas, the water cycle in nature, which is also known as the hydrological cycle, describes the permanent movement of water on, above, and below the surface of the Earth. Whereas the sun radiates solar energy on the oceans and land, the water evaporates to evaporation vapor, and the ice and snow are converted directly to water vapor through the sublimation process. Evaporation involves evapotranspiration of water from the plant and soil, and advection air currents carry water vapor to the atmosphere as it condenses into clouds due to cold temperatures. Air currents also move clouds around the globe as clouds particles grow and collide with each other and fall to the ground in the form of precipitation. Some rain falls on the ground in the form of snow, which can accumulate to be ice peaks and refrigerators that store water for thousands of years. Snow rubble can also melt and flow on the surface of the earth in the form of melted snow, as most rain falls back to the oceans or flow on land in the form of surface runoff. Part of this surface runoff joins rivers through valleys and drainage basins in nature. waterways may flow into the ocean, and this runoff is stored as fresh water in the lakes. It is worth noting that not all surface runoff flows into rivers, but much of it reaches the ground through infiltration or infiltrates deep into the ground to feed groundwater, which stores vast amounts of fresh water for long periods of time. Some of this leakage remains close to the surface of the earth and can leak back into surface waters and oceans as groundwater discharge. Some groundwater comes out as springs of fresh water through natural openings in the surface of the earth, and over time the water returns back to the ocean where the main water cycle began. Follow our YouTube channel to receive all that is new and advanced in the field of water resources and project completion, in a professional format through the use of computer programs for hydrological and hydraulic modeling, as well as programs for modeling different irrigation methods. Follow us step by step from one video to another. And don't forget to make a like and subscribe to the channel.